When we started operating on the 5th of September, there was a conflict of legal norms between which what amount of cases to should we expect, between 200-300 to 3,000. And in the mid of September, a new law of Ukraine passed regarding that only the big cases should go to the High Anti-Corruption Court of Ukraine, which were investigated by National Anti-Corruption Bureau and prosecuted by Special Anti-Prosecutor Office. At the moment, we approximately received 104 cases. Only 8 of them are new cases. All other cases, 96 cases, were brought from other courts throughout Ukraine. And since we are hearing the cases in the panels of 3 judges in simple courts, such cases were heard only by 1 judge. And since we have jurisdiction of all over Ukraine, I think it's not enough to operate very quickly on the cases. In previous courts, in simple courts, they were scheduled once for 2 or 3 months. So nowadays, if it is 2 weeks or 3 weeks, it's rapid already. But we have to, there is always somewhere where we can aim and go on further. One of the reasons why I went to this competition of High Anti-Corruption Court was additional guarantees of the judges, including one of the main guarantees was that we are provided with 24/7, I would say, security of every judge, and if he asked, also of his family and his assets. At the moment, there is no such security, and since we already have such high-profile cases, I think we need such safety, because, for example, we have judges who have 2-3 children, 3 daughters. How can the judge be positive and think on his case when he's afraid of his children when they go into school, because they can be approached mentally or physically by other, and it means not only by the people who are accused, but only by other people, by society who is not satisfied with the decision of the judge. The role of the judge of the court, not only to say that he's that this person has committed a crime, but to educate and to satisfy that, and to be sure that the rule of law rules.